50 years ago, if you were flying an RC plane, you were probably using something called PWM 50 Hertz between your wireless receiver and your servos. How it worked is that you had all of your signals in a single wireless link that was then separated into six signals here. When we started developing drones, we realized that 50 Hertz wasn't fast enough, and there's a whole lot of space between your updates. That's how we got PWM at 490 Hertz. Why not go faster? Because you already have your updates at 2.04 milliseconds, and we have 2 milliseconds that represents 100%. Then we got to OneShot. OneShot synchronizes the update between the CPU and the ESC, and it reduces the length of your 100% value from 2000 microseconds to 125 microseconds. Then we got UAVCAN. UAVCAN is a digital signal. It's often used on bigger drones. It's differential, meaning that you have two control signals that resist noise a lot better. And finally, it's bidirectional, meaning you can get data back from your ESC. That concludes our summary of ESC protocols that are commonly used. We've made a lot of effort to support as many ESC protocols as possible with our tools. If you want more information, don't hesitate to contact us or leave a comment below. Thanks for watching.